Psalm 5 verse 3. In the morning, O Lord, I will direct my song and my prayer unto you, and will look up. Amen. Good morning, Lord. This is the day that you have made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. With gratitude, I thank you for preserving my life for one more day. With gratitude, I thank you for your ultimate gift of love for me, in the form of your Son and the sacrifice of his life on my behalf. Because of this overwhelming gift that I often cannot comprehend, I humbly submit to you. I know, Lord, that I am a mere human and cannot instruct you, but you, Lord, can instruct me. So teach me your ways, that I may rely on your faithfulness. Teach me to number my days and to use my time wisely. I don't know what this day holds, but I know that you hold the day. It was you that laid the foundations of the earth and therefore understands every part of it. I know that you keep the sun in the skies, the stars in place, and have created this earth for me to inhabit and enjoy. Throughout this day, may I be keenly aware of your presence in everything I do. As I commute to work, drop children off at school, keep house, and speak with my neighbors, may my life be a living example. May others see Christ in me. There are many that are hurting in this world. May I be a salve to someone today, Lord, in a way that I cannot even imagine. May my word be seasoned with salt and minister grace to all that hear. May my actions be aligned with your word. I pray for wisdom that is peaceable, gentle, and approachable, with lots of mercy and fairness. You say unlimited supply of wisdom is available to me if I simply ask. So I pray for wisdom to know how to deal with the many people and situations that will cross my path. I pray for protection throughout this day. Protect from harm and evil. Go before me, to the left and right of me, and behind me. Order my steps so that I walk worthy of your calling throughout this day. May I be attuned to your prompting, whether it shows up as a gentle thug or a strong conviction. I pray for reconciliations in family, in nations, and to you. I pray that all may come to know you and be reconciled back to you. Remove fear and anxiety. As believers, you have not given us a spirit of fear, but of love, power, and a sound mind. So when we are fearful, may we remember your love for us and use that love as the impetus to love others and see situations differently. May we tap into the power that you have given us, for we are never alone because you have not left us comfortless. May your wisdom be the underpinnings of our sound mind. May we remember that we don't have to be anxious, and we are tempted to be anxious or worrisome. May we verbalize our concern to you and then leave them there as you instructed us. Our worries does us no good and limit us, and you do more with our worries than we ever could. So help us to turn all our anxious thoughts and nerve-wracking situation over to you to truly do that and trust that you are working. That you are working all things together for our good because you love us. That you are working in ways that we cannot comprehend because your ways supersede ours. And that in this working you are molding us continuously into masterpieces fit for your use. You are increasing our faith and our capacity to love. As a child of yours, Lord, I know that I am your masterpiece, though I feel so far from it. Help me to remember my worth in you when I'm faced with challenging situations, when I feel depressed. Help me to remember I am fearfully and wonderfully made in your image, a replica of you, that you love me so much you thought that I was worth dying for. I don't know too many people that would die for me, but you did, and I'm eternally grateful and humble for the unseen. Lord, thank you. You are beyond understanding. You are abundant. You are mine, and I am yours. I submit all to you today. In the name of Jesus.